Our school's purpose is about ensuring that nobody's left behind or forgotten. And we're quite mindful of the fact that we are isolated, and we don't want that to be a perceived barrier to our students' education. So it was really important for us that we engage with it heavily, because we wanted to ensure that our students here had just as much access to students anywhere in the metropolitan area. There was at the time, I think, a group of four of us that formed a STEM committee. And we started by building a STEM strategic plan that looked over the next 3 years and what it was we actually wanted to achieve.
Once we defined our school's STEM vision and our purpose, then we were tracking our STEM projects back to, is that really part of our vision? Is that really part of our purpose?
That's all right.
For us, STEM is the art of integration, and it's integrating those curriculum areas along with those general capabilities to design an open-ended project-based learning experience for our students. But the key importance in all of that is, before we ask our students to engage in the project, we actually have to explicitly teach them the content, and we have to explicitly teach them those 21st century learning skills, because then when they come to the project, we know they've got the skills to be successful.
Cardboard? Rope, which we'll need for the pulley, beautiful.
They actually come up what they need. So, we'll need recycled material. Where are we going to get that? Oh, we can buy it. Is that recycled? No, it's not.
Do you see how easy that is?
Yes.
And
yes,
you could probably do that with...
They've got a planning tool. So I've been able to sit down and plan with Tanya, who's been driving it as the coordinator of it. It was nice to just have that planning document, so that we could all talk the same language. But it also allows us our own entry points of where we're at and how far we want to take a project. But it also gives us someone else to bounce ideas off.
We're going to need some of the sides, yeah.
The resilience level in failing at something was quite low. So now it's like, oh, we failed. What can we do? And then they'll sort it out. They'll think of another solution.
They don't just accept the first thought that comes into their mind. They'll talk about ideas, like they'll ask each other questions, and you'll hear them going, oh, that's a really good idea, I didn't think of that, let's try that. My little ones love it because it's an opportunity for them to shine. I've got one in my room who finds reading challenging and writing challenging, but his creativity, when he's given a STEM challenge, is mind-blowing. And he loves it, and he blossoms because he's just got that freedom and his world doesn't rotate around reading and writing.
It's good fun, and we use different strategies every time.
I like the gears.
Yeah, the gears.
The biggest support that TDS has offered is, obviously, given our, again, relative isolation, the opportunity to have that face-to-face interaction with other like-minded schools who are also working in the STEM space, and getting to work with other schools who are doing that at the same time, has really built our capacity.
Gives each student the opportunity to gain self-confidence in their own ability.
Take a round of talk first.
It's just getting back to thinking about what is really good integration and how to create those really rich assessment opportunities for students that make learning meaningful.
Excited to learn, continue to learn, and add to what I can do and what I'm about to learn how to do.
It just makes it all the better when they finally nail it. Their faces are just beautiful.